Jaliat Namuwaya, a journalist with Vision Group, says she got to know about her condition of having endometriosis after she had failed to conceive. Namuwaya shares her painful experience.
It started as infertility, so I had a problem with getting pregnant, but I wasn't having that much pain. So I'd moved to various gynecs to know why was I not getting pregnant. That's when I moved to various gynecs, but for them, they would tell me, you are no more, you are no more, you are no more. But my periods were like any other periods. They were not deadly periods. Until one day, when I was in my bedroom, and then I decided to look into my umbilical cord. When I looked into the umbilical cord, there was something black which was growing inside. It is called a black nodule. Because I was already inquisitive, very eager to know what is happening, why am I not getting pregnant? Immediately I went to Google. So when I went to Google, I put there a black nodule in my umbilical cord. Woo. Google told me whatever would happen to me in the future. So Google told me that what that black nodule, usually people with that black nodule in the umbilical cord, it is hard for them to get pregnant. It is Google which told me that it's endometriosis. It is Google which told me that years are going to come, or time is going to come, when you are going to start bleeding through the umbilical cord during your periods. Woo, guess what? After like three to four years, I started seeing whatever Google said.
Another Katharina Simwe, 22, has battled with the disease for close to 12 years. Asimwe also highlights on her story.
So I've had pain for all 12 years throughout, and I didn't know I had endometriosis or adenomyosis until very recently that I came in touch with the Endometriosis Foundation that linked me up to doctors that were very helpful in diagnosing the condition. Okay, so the pain has always been around the time of ovulation and during my periods, when I'm on my periods. But gradually it has become something more chronic. I live with it every day. It only gets worse or better depending on what day of the cycle it is.
When given proper treatment, some women are able to conceive and have children, as the case was for Jemima Nakasanje, a patient with endometriosis. Nakasanje also shares her story.
The money is not there. Our places of work gives us insurance and medical and everything, and that's very beautiful. But most of the time, they do not cover these extra complicated diseases. But what I know is that there is hope. There are so many ladies that have endometriosis and have been written off as barren or not able to have kids at all. And yet I know from my story that there is hope. I would encourage each and every one of us, the endo warriors, to not give up. In the small capacity that you can, seek treatment.
Dr. Spire Chigongo, who is a senior consultant gynecologist at Henrob Hospital Zana, notes that endometriosis is one of the biggest cause of infertility and cautions women not to regard painful menstrual period as normal.
Most of them will come complaining of menstrual pain. Every month they will have some sort of pain, which is usually more significant than usual. If any woman has pain that is strong enough to stop her from doing her usual activities, we say this is not normal pain. If you have pain that is severe enough to send you to a pharmacy to buy medication, to need any sort of admission in hospital, then we say that this is not normal pain. So people should not normalize menstruation.
There is light at the end of the tunnel, and many women can have children after treatment. However, the biggest barrier is the knowledge gap and the need to sensitize young girls about the warning signs, as well as health workers.
Gap. A lot of patients do not know about endometriosis. They ignore these symptoms. As I said earlier, everyone normalizes pain, and by the time we see them, they've waited for 8 years to get a diagnosis of endometriosis, and this is a very big problem. So we have a knowledge gap, not just to the patients, but even the doctors. The doctors, the nurses, and the medical fraternity do not know about endometriosis. Largely, the majority of them will treat it as some sort of infection. They call it PID. Women get antibiotics.
Grace Nagawa, who is the chief executive of FISA, Endometriosis Foundation Uganda, explains how the agency supports the women to live productive lives.
Uganda has been in existence for now 5 years. What we do is we create awareness and sensitize the public about endometriosis, including health professionals. We do counseling and health education. We support ladies with endometriosis achieve their goals. We promote economic empowerment for the ladies, and we also link them to the right professionals that can handle this illness, because it's a very complicated disease. And being that it's really an illness that is hard to be diagnosed and detected, it takes long for these ladies to be detected.
Story compiled by Agnes Chotalengeride for the news.